Following the collapse of Alitalia in 2021, a new Italian flag carrier emerged, called ITA Airways. But what is Italy's new flag carrier like? Today we take a look at what it's like to fly on ITA Airways on board an A320 on their busiest route, on a short flight from Rome to Milan. Welcome to Rome's Leonardo da Vinci Fiumicino Airport, which was originally opened in 1961 and is currently Italy's busiest airport. This airport has three terminals, but I believe Terminal 5 is currently not in use. My flight will depart from Terminal 1, which is generally used for domestic and Schengen area flights. Now inside the terminal, I was able to check these boards to find out that check-in was located at counters 11 to 20. Once I located check-in for today's flight, I found that there was a fairly long line. For people that had a flight which was departing very soon, the staff let them skip the queue. Also, there was someone there just opening the lanes. I'm not sure if they were told they were allowed to cut through and just couldn't be bothered to use the already open ones, or if they're just trying to skip the line. Just before I got to the end of the line, because my flight was departing pretty soon, I got moved to the front of the line. Something that I didn't expect was that you still have to pay for seat selection at check-in. And the check-in agent wasn't the warmest. The check-in agent said they couldn't change the seat or check for an upgrade, so we had to go to ticketing. Maybe I'm wrong, but I think the agent could have done that and they were just trying to get out of it. We went to ticketing and the agent was very helpful. They said that my fare was not eligible for an upgrade and seat selection would cost me 11 euros. Anyway, now that check-in is done, it's time to head through security. There was a waiting time on the display, which I think is really great. Security probably only took me 3 to 5 minutes. It took a little bit longer because the bag scanning movement was slow despite being quite automated. Now airside, there looks to be plenty of duty-free and high-end shopping. There also looks to be a food hall with a fair amount of options for food. It looked to me as though there was a section of gates where you had to go through passport control to actually get to the gates. In October 2020, it was reported that ITA Airways was to buy several assets from Alitalia, including things such as the brand and flight codes. Now, there's a whole bunch of big words that are supposed to describe how Alitalia could not just simply become ITA Airways, but I don't really understand that. So basically, I understand that the European Commission essentially said that Alitalia could not just be reorganised into ITA Airways, and also that ITA should not retain Alitalia's brand. So on the 15th of October 2021, ITA Airways commenced operations as a separate airline to Alitalia, which ceased operations on the same day. ITA Airways was and still is a government majority owned airline. But in a very recent development, at the start of this month, July 2024, the European Commission granted permission for the Lufthansa Group to acquire a 41% stake in ITA Airways. So while the government will still be the majority shareholder at this point, the Lufthansa Group will still have a major stake in the airline. ITA Airways is currently in the SkyTeam Alliance, but I understand the airline will leave SkyTeam and join Star Alliance in roughly 2 or 3 years' time. Since its launch, ITA Airways has taken delivery of several new and modern aircraft. Its fleet currently consists of 99 aircraft, with a further 21 on order, though some of those aircraft on order will replace older aircraft such as the A319. ITA Airways' route network currently has a focus on flights within Europe and to the United States from its hub in Rome, but it also has flights to the Middle East, Africa, South America, South Asia and East Asia, with ITA Airways having announced a new route to Bangkok in Thailand just recently. So now that you know a bit about ITA Airways, it's time to board. There were lots of people lined up for boarding in good time. Boarding started a little early. The announcement stated that there was already no space in the overhead lockers and so other bags must be checked in. There was quite a queue for boarding in the jet bridge, but at least there's glass windows so I get some good views of our plane. Speaking of, Echo India, Delta Sierra Yankee will be my ride to Milan. It's a 2008-built Airbus A320-216 equipped with two CFM engines, which was delivered new to Air One in 2009 before being transferred to Alitalia in 2014 as Air One ceased operations and parent company Alitalia took over some of its aircraft and routes. This aircraft is one of ITA Airways' first aircraft. ITA Airways acquired this aircraft from Alitalia in October 2021. After a nice initial welcome from the crew, welcome on board ITA Airways A320 CEO. I believe ITA Airways A320s have two different but similar configurations. This one features 171 Recaro BL3250 slimline seats in a 3-3 layout. But there's a dynamically sized business class cabin at the front where middle seats are blocked. I believe this is still the same cabin that Alitalia installed before it was transferred to ITA Airways.
Speed up for the operations, we can inform you that the compartments are reserved for choice of bike items only.
My seat for today will be 16A in the economy class cabin. Now let's take a quick look at the seat features. First up, legroom is, to be honest, really bad. Some of the worst I've experienced, and it would be the worst I've experienced on a full-service carrier, I think. It felt like only around 28 inches to me. Inside the seat back pocket, you'll find a sick bag and a safety card. My seat back pocket, particularly at the bottom, was quite dirty. There's a pretty standard tray table which can be moved back and forth, but you can't fold it. Then up here, it looks like there used to be a seat back entertainment screen installed, which has since been removed. But that's just a guess. On the side of the seat, you'll find a coat hook. And on the side of my seat, there's an audio port for what looks like audio entertainment, but there also seems to be controls that were potentially for the entertainment screen. So I'm not exactly sure what it was. Whatever it wasn't broken on all of the seats. There's no proper adjustable headrest, but the seat back does curve a bit at the top. And by the way, seat back padding is not bad. And there's a look at the overhead panel. I thought it was interesting how the floor, which is normally the dirty part of the seat, was quite clean, but the rest of the seat was quite dirty.
Questo bagaglio è in corso questo istante per azioni rallentate a causa delle condizioni meteorologiche, vi chiedo ancora qualche istante di pazienza. Before you, ladies and gentlemen, once more, welcome on board this Airbus 320 destination Milano Linate on behalf of ITA Airways and my crew, captain speaking. While the procedure is completed, cargo loading will be in a while. I'm asking you some moments more of patience because the weather condition today in Rome, we fly 45 minutes after takeoff. Cloudy weather initially, ferry cruise, again cloudy. In Milano Linate, presently it's not raining, it's expected to be. We'll see you in the approach. The crews are waiting for us. What's more, thank you.
Chiedere il tavolino, per lo schienare la poltrona in posizione
vertica.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain speaking. This time Fiumicino seems to be really overcrowded because the weather, holding time before taking off about several planes before us, so that's why we are still here waiting at the parking area. I'm asking you some moments for patience and hold detailed information. Thank you.
It sounds like we've got a delay due to bad weather and congestion. After having been on the ground for roughly an hour, the crew came around offering water, something I was glad to see. But I would expect that from a full-service carrier when there's a delay of around an hour on the ground.
So, gentlemen, your captain, we've just been cleared to pushing out the plane, so we're going to start our flight. Thank you for your cooperation.
It's now time for pushback, a little less than 1 hour and 10 minutes late. By the way, it wasn't just our flight or ITA Airways flights that were delayed. It was a lot of flights at this airport.
Ladies and gentlemen, for your safety, we kindly ask you to fasten your seatbelts.
we could take off, there was also a bit of waiting involved on the taxiway, but at least I got some really cool views of some other planes. It's now time for takeoff on runway 25. Once we got airborne, I was able to see this Iran Air Airbus A300 parked at a stand. Even at a distance, it was so cool to be able to see this aircraft, and when I was in Istanbul, I was able to see a Mahan Air Airbus A340-200. So I feel quite lucky that I was able to see two of some of the rarest Airbus planes still in service. If you're not familiar with flying domestically on ITA Airways, then you'd probably expect either nothing for this short flight or just some bottled water. No, on this flight, ITA Airways offered water, Coke, Coke Zero, orange juice, pear juice, as well as tea and coffee. By the way, flight time was roughly 50 minutes. It was cool to see that they still had a little bit of Alitalia branded equipment. I went for a pear juice and a tea. Since I didn't ask for white tea or milk, it was just plain tea. The pear juice, which I don't think I've had on a plane before, was very nice. It tasted like proper pear juice rather than artificial flavouring. It was quite thick for a juice. Now, I'm not sure about this, but I believe that the crew didn't actually get to finish the service for all of the passengers. And upon looking at other reviews of similar flights on ITA Airways, I think that's probably what happened. But again, I'm not sure. I will save my thoughts on that for the conclusion. After the service, the crew soon came around to collect rubbish.
Il tempo a terra è nuvoloso e la temperatura è di 15 gradi centigradi. Ladies and gentlemen, the captain informs you that we now approaching Milano Linate Airport, where we expect to land in about 15 minutes while the conditions on the ground are partially cloudy and temperature is 15 degrees Celsius. Thank you.
As we're already descending into Milan, allow me to conclude my flight with ITA Airways. Check-in in Rome wasn't the greatest check-in experience. There was quite a decent line, but that happens, no big deal. But the way some people were given priority or would just cut the line was interesting. The check-in agent wasn't rude, but wasn't very friendly. When I realised I hadn't paid for advanced seat selection and had been randomly allocated, I asked if I could have a window seat, and the check-in agent said that one of us, I was travelling with some family, already had a window seat, but none of us did, and it's not like the corresponding letters were unusual, just the usual A, B, C, D, E, F. So either the check-in agent didn't know much about seat numbering, or was just trying to get out of changing my seat, my guess being the latter. When I said that I knew there wasn't any window seat allocated, the agent said they couldn't change it, so I had to go to the ticket office. I shared my thoughts on this earlier. Thankfully, the ticket office agent was more helpful and I was able to get a window seat for a fee. Boarding started a little early and was a bit slow. Once on board, the first set of crew gave a normal welcome, but the other crew members didn't. But that's not a big deal at all. The seat was honestly somewhat crap. The seat back padding was fine, but legroom was poor, the seat was a bit dirty, and also the audio entertainment, or whatever it was broken. Although I'm unsure if it functions at any seat. I don't know that the delay on the ground was really ITA Airways' fault, so I'll try not to let that affect my summary. But what I will let affect my summary is how it was handled. They kept us informed and gave us water, which is good. Once in the air, I was surprised to see a proper drink service. I really appreciated this, but I estimated that roughly the first 8 or 9 rows of economy that I don't think got served probably didn't appreciate it so much. As much as I did enjoy the service, it's not good for the passengers that don't get it. So I think it may be a better idea to just do tea, coffee and water, or even just bottled water would be acceptable. And I expect that this will change if the Lufthansa Group takes majority ownership of ITA Airways in the future. I do appreciate the thought of the drink service though. The cabin crew seemed to do their job well. They weren't particularly warm, but there was little time for it. Overall, I had a very average experience with ITA Airways. It has its strong suits, but more weak points based on my experience. I do believe though that their newer aircraft, including the A320, which sometimes operates on this route, have better seats. And I also believe their long-haul economy class to be better, something that I would like to try at some point. But my experience with ITA Airways was still better than my experience on Lufthansa, so that's something. Now enjoy the rest of the approach and landing at Milan Linate Airport. Being ITA Airways' busiest route, it operates plenty of daily flights between Rome Fiumicino and Milan Linate, mostly on the A320 family aircraft, but there's also routinely flights on the A220 family of aircraft, which I believe offer the best product.
Ladies and gentlemen, you will disembark through the forward and rear doors of the aircraft. The shuttle bus will take you to the terminal. Thank you, arrivederci.
As I disembarked via bus, I got some great views of our A320. What do you think of the ITA Airways livery? It's quite a unique one, and I personally think that it looks particularly good on the A350.
Hello.
pretty new Italian airline, Aero Italia, is the only other airline that offers flights between Rome and Milan. It offers slightly cheaper ATR flights between Rome and mostly Milan-Bergamo Airport, but also Milan-Linate Airport. Keep in mind, I'm not sure how good the airline is or isn't. I'd like to take this time to thank you all so much for watching today's video. A like and subscription if you enjoyed would help me and the channel out a lot, and would be very much appreciated, but if you don't want to, that's okay too. Feel free to check out my Instagram if you like, at aviation763_, where I post updates of my trips. And last but most certainly not least, thank you so much to all of my incredible Patreons for helping to make these videos possible. Their support is truly so much appreciated, and I couldn't do what I do without them. Once again, I'd like to thank you all so much for watching, I hope you have an amazing day, and I look forward to hopefully seeing you in my next one, next Saturday at 5 p.m. Melbourne time.